Welcome back. We are, let's see, we were in the meadow when we left off, trying to go find her Cosmog.
No, Nebby.
Come on, Jay. Let's see what we have here.
His name is Nebby. His name is Nebby Paulson.
Oh my god.
Hey, that's a good movie.
Yeah, no, it was. Fight Club is a solid movie for sure.
Fight Club? I was talking about the third Harry Potter movie.
Oh, clearly. My bad. Rookie mistake.
Such a nude.
So since we last recorded last night, I have played... Both of us have played past this point in the game, but that's okay.
Not that much.
Yeah, not by much. I mean, I basically just made it to the second island. Also, do you know, is there any purpose at this point into going to this cave down here? It's like there were Zubats and Diglets in there, and if you come out the other side, it looked like you needed to be able to ride a Lapras to go anywhere.
Oh, wait.
You know what I'm talking about?
Cave?
So if you go down here, to the left there's an entrance to a cave.
I don't know. I think I didn't go over to the left, because I was just like, I don't care.
Yeah, all that's in there is like a couple items, Zubats and Diglets, and then... The exit comes out to, like, you just have a little bit of beach, and then there's water where you can obviously surf and go find other stuff, but...
Interesting.
I won't bother with it now, since I don't think we can do anything there. I am gonna try and catch this thing, though, because I think it's pretty rare.
Quarter-quarter, you?
Yep.
I don't know, man. I saw two when I was in there. Also, this place is called the Oratorio Meadow, by the way.
Well, when I was playing through here earlier, I spent a lot of time in this grass and I only found one.
Oh, I found two in a row. Two out of the four guys that I fought there were
that.
So, I think you just had shitty luck. And by shitty, I mean your luck was
possible.
Too good and you weren't seeing the common guy.
That is possible. I just kept running into Cottonies and Cutie Flies. Stay in the great ball, come on, man.
I don't remember... Oh, yeah, I did catch one. I'm trying to remember if I caught one. So I remember it being fucking obnoxious, but I think I eventually... I think I put it to sleep with Ghastly.
Ah, I can't do that. I think the only status I have on my team right now is...
Electric, which
yeah.
Can't work on that because it's electric flying.
I guess I could poison it with Grimer. It's a little bit of a risk in case it dies before I can catch it, but, eh. Should be okay.
Does poison help with catching?
Yeah, all statuses do. I think, it's like, sleep helps the most, but they all give some, like, multiplier to the catch rate.
Hmm.
Oh, god damn it.
There you go. Now you'll catch it real easy. Now that it's impossible to catch.
Well, this is turning into a longer ordeal than I planned.
Come on, man.
I don't even think this is gonna one-shot. Oh, god. Alright, I'm abandoning this plan. Not worth... Fuck, I couldn't even get away.
Oh, there you go. Now they're doing helping hand on each other. You're gonna get fucking destroyed, man.
I just don't have anything good to kill an electric flying type at all.
Ground. Do you not have rock?
Nope. I'm looking forward to getting a Rockruff, but we have to beat the first island so we can get Tauros first.
Spoiler alert, by the way.
Oh yeah. Whoops.
We both played a little bit past this. Not that it really matters. Then Jay just starts throwing out plot spoilers. Yeah, you catch Mewtwo in like 5 minutes, and your mom dies.
That'd be pretty intense for a Pokemon
stuff.
Game.
You catch Mewtwo in a lot of Pokemon games.
I was talking about the mom dying part, but
Oh, isn't that implied in most of the game?
Yeah, totally.
Well, not about your mom, though, but about your dad. Like, where's your dad now? Dead.
It's probably actually Professor Kukui.
Can you say that again? Professor what?
Kukui? I'm pretty sure I said it
Kukui?
Right.
Kukui?
No, is it not two syllables? Or not three syllables?
No. You never pronounce an I on its own. Kukui. Come on, Jay. You know better than that.
Do I, though?
No. I'm trying to remember some of the ways you used to pronounce Pokemon names.
They were pretty bad. Not gonna lie. They were not great.
I don't think this one was you, but I do know somebody... who was it? Somebody used to pronounce Growlithe as Growlithe.
Okay, that was not me.
And I was like, really? And they're like, yeah, it's got Grow in the name. And I was like, hey, what's a Grow with an L at the end? Growl. And I was like, there you go.
Sounds like a Patrick thing to me.
Probably. No offense, Patrick, but I mean, whatever.
Jesus Christ.
No, Tapu Koko. Jesus, man. This thing forever.
Well, that was a productive 5 minutes.
You really bit off more than you could chew. By that, I mean, suck in this game. Not like me. Ah, yes, Caterpie.
Good old Caterpie.
The best pseudo-legendary in the game.
Apparently I need to level up because my team sucks, let's just kill it.
I mean, catching it gives you experience too.
Yeah, but why would I want to catch Caterpie?
Because Butterfree is awesome. Although that's too high level, you're going to miss out on Gust and Confusion, but...
Yep.
That's why you should have caught one on the first route. Catch a nice level 5 Caterpie.
I did do that on my Sun playthrough. I caught everything.
Mr. Bragg's a lot over here. Caught everything. Yeah, kind of a big deal. Caught everything. Ash comes to me for advice on where to find Pokemon. Which, like, isn't even a compliment.
Yeah, I was gonna say, is that really saying much?
He's, like, the worst trainer ever. not that I've watched the more recent stuff, but at least until the recent stuff, worst trainer ever. Just absolutely terrible.
Yeah, he's pretty god-awful.
Pretty what awful?
Pretty god-awful.
Tapu awful? I don't understand what this word is that you're saying.
Fair enough. I wonder if I can change what my bag looks like. I do kind of like the watermelon.
I'm about to do that sweet, there's no Pokemon Center and I need to heal trick.
Which is putting shit in a PC?
Yeah, flush
out. Are you at the daycare? The PC.
Dude, spoilers, come on.
But where else would that be? Where there's a PC but no Pokemon Center?
I mean, there are other places that it could be. It doesn't. Not everywhere has to have a Pokemon Center.
Alright, well, like found Cosmog.
I like how you copied my hat.
I mean, there was only like two options.
Yeah, you didn't have to get one.
Fair enough.
Oh man, how do you think he's going to beat you this time?
How could he?
Good joke.
No, it wasn't.
Did you come up with it all on your own? It's almost like you stole it from me.
Alright, let's go, Grimer.
Shaolin Showdown?
I'm still amazed by how just like
you're gonna take some damage
relatively
that.
Good that Grimer is in this game. Its typing is just so good.
Oh, fuck yeah.
How it's late does Grimer evolve? Is it like 37?
Something like I that. Believe it is 37.
Okay. That is the one downside. It's gonna be a Grimer for a while.
A who? You mean a Napoleon?
Yep. Neapolitan. Yeah, also, so I decided to just look up how Grubbin and Chargebug evolve. And I'm probably gonna ditch Grubbin from the team because apparently, spoilers, once it evolves
no,
into
no, don't! No spoilers!
Alright, well.
You shouldn't have even spoiled it and looked up where he evolved. I'm disappointed in you.
Moral of the story is, it's not gonna evolve for a while, so I'm probably not gonna keep it on the team. As much as I would like to have a Vikavolt.
Spoiler heavy episode over here. They're just like, yeah, I know that normally you shouldn't just like throw out all of the details of a game, but I'm just gonna literally tell you everything and leave nothing to imagination or to discover on your own.
Tailwind back to Route 3, really. Did you fight this guy?
Yeah.
You actually had an interesting strategy. I guess we'll get to that.
Or will we? How do you know he's a trainer?
Because he just said he was when I talked to him.
No, he didn't.
He said, I'll fight you once I've beat everybody else
in the
route.
No, he said he wouldn't fight you unless you could beat all the trainers on the route. That doesn't mean he's gonna fight you. That's just saying that, like, it's guaranteed that if you don't beat all of them, he won't.
Technically, you are correct.
Take a freshman level logic class in college. Another Growlithe.
This team, as it stands, also doesn't have anything for fire types.
Sure it does. Use Bubble Beam.
Yeah, but his special attack is terrible.
So? Use Crab Hammer. You have that unlocked, right?
Yeah, totally. Alright. Barkanine.
Such a terrible name. Oh, good lord, alright. I don't know why I've switched to video. Oh, so I finally learned Eruption.
Okay.
With my fire cat.
I bet.
Yeah, man. It learns Eruption at level 17.
That wouldn't be broken at all.
Well, it's based on your health.
Yeah, but still 150 base now. Also, see, yeah, this guy, if you didn't notice, said he was a red card user, and what that does is when you attack his Pokemon, assuming you make physical contact, it forces you to switch out, kind of like Roar.
Two things wrong with that. If you kill them, it doesn't, and it's not physical contact.
They changed that?
I mean, I definitely hit him with a special type move, and I think it was Thundershock, and got switched out.
Okay.
So.
I think I'll probably be able to OKO both of his guys, but when I fought him in Sun, my type matchup wasn't as good, so I didn't OKO him, and he... Well, there we go. And he set up Stealth Rocks with the Rockruff, and then also had Yawn on Slowpoke. Yep, there it is. Oh, without the Stealth Rocks, it's not as good of a strategy, but that was kind of funny. It's actually a fairly legitimate strategy you had going on. Also, I like how the Ace Trainers look in this game. That's what this guy is, right? An Ace Trainer?
No. He's a lass.
Thanks.
Oh, good lord.
What was his name?
Something. I don't know, you mashed A too quickly.
Something with a K M.
With a K M. Letters are hard.
They really are, though.
Yeah, maybe if English isn't your first language. Apparently walking is hard, too.
You don't like running into everything?
Not usually. Generally find that it wastes time.
All right. Hey, side quest.
Sort of. There's no way to track it.
Well, yeah. Show him a Rockruff. Okay, I can do that.
We just have to show him the Pokédex entry.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. Well, I think you have to catch it, but you don't have to bring it with you.
I gotcha, okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of nice. Alright, so it's time to fight the first gym leader, and he has fighting types.
No, we already fought the first gym leader. It was the Raticate.
Yeah, you're right. Make sure we healed up. I'm kind of hoping that our starter can kind of solo this, because we do not have much else for fighting types. I mean, Grimer resists them, but it can't really hit them back very hard either.
Does it resist them? Because it's part dark.
Okay, it's probably neutral then. Because I know... Yeah, it would be neutral then. Poison definitely resists fighting. Hala, the kahuna of Mele Mele Island. Alright, well, let's beat this guy. Hopefully.
Nah, I hope we lose.
I wouldn't be that surprised. It's a cool animation, though.
Wait, where'd the animation go? I thought we were fighting a swirling vortex of death.
Like, I was just randomly people watching in the background.
I mean, you mean the people from the city? That this is happening on the stage in the center?
Yep, those people.
Okay. I want them to start holding up, like, signs. That are like, boo, you suck.
That'd be pretty great.
Chase you out of the town with torches and pitchforks.
So yeah, for this fight in my Sun playthrough, I was just using a Rowlet. I mean, a Rufflet, sorry. And man, that thing destroyed everything. I'm sad that we can't get that in this one. It's like the strongest thing on my team. Although, isn't that one that doesn't evolve until super late?
I think it's like 50.
Jesus, okay. I may not keep that.
I could be slightly above, but I think it's like 50. Cause actually, everything on the route that you find that on in Black and White is like that high, because you can find
it's like Hydreigon
Bisharp
and
there
stuff.
Too. Well, Hydreigon's past that in the mountain, but you can find Bisharp there, and that evolves at 55.
Yeah, you're right. Well, I may not keep that on my team then. I don't know if I can deal with it for that long. It was good for this point in the game, though.
You should have caught a Vullaby.
That is not near as good.
It's probably Vullaby, actually, when I think about it. But I've never heard anybody say it.
I've heard Volibee, but...
Well, I've...
Volibee does kind
of make
sense.
I've heard a lot of people say that, but... That's also what I generally just say. But I don't have any technical proof.
Alright, well... Since our starter had a good matchup against that guy, that was pretty simple.
Man, you should have used the strategy I used. It was so much cheaper.
You're saying with Ghastly, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I used the use curse, then put them to sleep, then heal yourself, and then basically just sit there and laugh, and use mean look and stuff like that while they're asleep.
Nice.
So it like does no damage and is basically pointless. Just do that. You're just like, alright, sure. That's totally gonna happen. Also, I don't think that that's a watermelon slice. I'm pretty sure it's grapefruit slice.
I'm not sure.
I mean, the bottom of it's yellow. It doesn't have a green rind at all.
It's true. Yay, we can ride Tauros now and break all the rocks.
What rocks? I need a visual example. Cut to visual example. And by that I mean just have to wait.
Yeah, I will go there shortly.
Man, you look stupid.
God, the riding gear looks so dumb. Like, I understand putting on the helmet, but why do we have to put on the whole riding suit? Why can't we just keep our normal clothes on?
It's so you don't, like, ruin your clothes. Get them all, like, dirty and torn up and stuff. And then, of course, you need elbow pads and knee pads and shin guards, because that's what anyone that rides any sort of motorcycle or whatever has to have legally. You're legally required to have all that stuff.
Uh-huh.
The president make you wear, like, a chin pad and really thick safety goggles.
Oh, nice. False weight. So it is time to get a Rockruff. After Lily shuts up. Yes, I will help. Pretty sure I don't have a choice.
No, don't help. Why did you say help? Damn it, Jay.
Now we can break all the rocks that were normally in the way before.
Like the one that you're running into right there that was not in the way at all.
Yeah, exactly. These are pretty rare, aren't they? I don't think I've actually seen one yet, even in my other game.
That was the first thing I saw on that route.
Really? Well, I guess I'll.
I like how you're just like, I'm pretty sure this is super rare, and I'm like, no, and then it's not. None of the things you're saying are rare. Pretty sure Dartrix is pretty rare.
God, dude, I found like 3 of those on Route 1. Hopefully this doesn't kill it. I don't think it will. Yeah. Stop doing that.
Oh, I love when they do that. It's my favorite thing.
Alright, well, that's my cue to not cash it.
I don't really know why you wanted to catch it anyways.
I don't either.
This isn't your normal playthrough, we're not catching everything.
I know, I'm just still in like...
It's certainly not useful.
I'm still just in the habit of doing it.
Also, you don't have to back up to do that, by the way. You can just run from right up against it. Just for future reference.
Good to know.
I can't do it, there's not enough room for me to back up and run. I do like that when you're, like, completely charging at full speed, you can't jump a ledge, and then you stop sprinting. And
I know, right? Makes perfect sense.
I mean, I'd have been fine if they automatically stopped you from running and just hopped you over, and then you went back into running, but... whatever, that's just me. Maybe they'll put a patch out after they watch our Let's Play. Hear our complaints specifically because, you know, we're so important. Whoa, you can catch Slowpoke on that route? I don't think I ever saw one. It must be super rare. I think it's got like a 1% chance of showing up.
Sounds about right. Oh my god, really? Do like two more pieces of grass. I think it's time to use a repel.
Use a repel now that there's 2 feet of grass left.
Well, we're about to go into a cave. And I'm sure the encounter rate will be awful in there too.
Yeah, but don't you want to catch a Geodude?
They're not in there. I wish they were. I would totally put one on the team.
Yeah, they are.
No, they're not.
Yeah, they are.
There's Rock and Rollos in here.
No, I'm talking about Geodude. From second gen.
Alright, so at the end of this cave is 10 Carat Hill, where you can find Rockruff.
Did you just use another repel?
No, I didn't. I almost did. Out of habit.
Yep, use another repel. Don't want to catch any of them damn Rockruffs.
That we came here specifically for.
Nice. Oh, there you go, catch that. That's even better.
Yeah, it's a perfect replacement.
Oh, I didn't say replacement. I said it'd be better.
Let's get that out of here.
It doesn't fulfill the same role, but it is a better Pokemon.
Hey, this is learning Spark, even though I'm about to get rid of it from the team.
Whoa, your Dartrix is learning Spark?
Yeah.
That's weird. Oh, god damn it. Fucking mishitting buttons.
There we go.
Oh, I did rename my my starter.
To what?
I'm not gonna tell you. You'll have to wait and see.
Alright. I'll be looking forward to that.
Yeah, man. Oh, I guess you did beat the final boss of the first island. Should we battle?
Yeah, we can do that. Try to catch this guy. Hopefully this won't be too painful to catch. Thank you for paralysis. You think a Thundershock will kill it? It's level 13 and I'm 16.
Probably not.
Let's find out.
How many Thundershocks does it take to kill a Rockruff? Let's find out.
Apparently two.
One? Two! A three? My favorite commercials. I miss those. Back from the 90s.
Yeah, they were not
quality.
I mean,
that fucking owl.
It was actually a Dartrix.
People are gonna have no idea what I'm talking about.
I mean, I would think so. Those were pretty common.
Yeah, back then. Yeah. How many people get on the internet and watch Pokemon videos that are from that time?
Just us, I guess.
Well, I don't watch Pokemon videos.
I do some. Let's see. Well, I'm gonna name this, even though it's a female, but oh well.
I don't get it. Is that a reference to
Lord of the Rings?
I said it first. My joke.
Totally meant to add that to the party. Whoops.
You should have the Taurus to your party.
I actually have one in my other game.
Spoiler! I don't know you could catch Taurus.
I didn't. I wonder traded and got one.
Whoa, trading? What kind of not purist are you?
Oh. So there's a TM up here. I don't remember what it was, but I think it was something pretty decent. As I run right past
Eruption.
It. Ooh, acrobatics. Yeah, that's actually pretty good. I wonder if our starter can learn that. That'd be a good move to have on it. Be a nice replacement.
Yeah, but then
tech.
You can't give him a held item. How's he going to hold the experience share?
I don't know. How is he going to hold the experience share?
Interesting.
I should probably grab the items in here that I ran straight past on the way.
Interesting. I think I might actually do that.
Do what?
Oh, Feebas, nice.
You found a Feebas?
No. But apparently they're in the place I'm about to go.
Interesting. Those are just always a pain to find in every game.
That's not true. They weren't a pain to find in first and second gen, because you couldn't find them. They didn't exist yet.
Yeah, that's about the only example, I suppose.
I feel like there's some game that they weren't that bad.
I'm just specifically thinking of third and fourth gen. They were awful.
Third gen was terrible. Fourth gen was...
It was just as bad.
Less
as
terrible.
Mount
it was
Coronet.
Not just as bad. There's only one lake.
Yeah, but I think it was like four tiles in that whole lake of like 500-something tiles.
In third gen, it was six tiles on the entire route.
Yeah, I mean, they were both pretty awful. And they changed every day, too. So you couldn't even just like systematically search it.
I mean, you could in a day.
Well, yeah, but...
So negative. It's impossible, you couldn't do it. Yeah, you can.
So there is also a TM you can get if you go back to the site of the first trial, but I'm not going to go all the way back there right now because it wasn't a very good TM from what I remember. But just heads up if you're watching, you can definitely go grab that with you, the Tauros.
Ooh, nice. Ooh, actually, I think this. Scout charge beam.
Nice. That's actually really good. Especially if you still have Magmine on your team.
Of course I do. What kind of person am I going to be not having a Magmine on my team?
Alright, well this seems like a good place to end this one off. We can start off the next episode by having a battle and then heading to the second island. So thanks for watching guys, and see you
Sounds
next time.
Good.